Good morning. So we are seeing the lesson Empowered Women Navigating the World. So we are seeing interview between the interviewer and the six crew members. Okay, so let us now continue the same. So the next question of the interviewer is, how adventurous was your trip? Okay. So how adventurous, so what is the meaning of adventurous is an unusual experience. Okay, so what is mean by adventure? You already know what is mean by adventure. Okay, so how adventurous, so how it gave a new experience. Okay, what was your new experience, how adventurous it was? Okay, that is the question of the interviewer. And Vartika Joshi, the commander of the, that is, sorry, the captain of the team is giving the answer. So her answer is, when we were crossing the Tasman Sea, we witnessed the brilliant southern lights from sea. It was rare to watch that in those months, that too from sea. We were absolutely awestruck as we are not expecting it. As we are not expecting it, to see the entire sky lit up in green light. There was bioluminescence, dolphins swimming in the wake of the boat like our neighbors, and a variety of sea creatures. We spotted a dead sperm whale once and we thought it was an island from a distance. It was so huge. We are not specialists, so whenever we spotted something in the sea, we had to Google it to learn more about the species, right? So when we are crossing the Tasman Sea, okay, so when they are crossing the, so during their expedition, when the team is crossing the Tasman Sea, it is the name of a sea, we witnessed the brilliant southern lights from sea. Okay, so what witnessed means they have seen. So what they have seen is, they have seen southern lights from the sea. Okay, so what is mean by southern light is, so it is also otherwise called as Aurora Australis. Okay, Aurora, A-U-R-O-R-A, Aurora Australis, A-U-S-T-R-A-L-I-S. Okay, southern light is also called as Aurora Australis. So what is mean by southern light is, actually it is a physical phenomenon. Okay, so it is a physical phenomenon that creates bright and colorful lights in the sky. So southern lights is also otherwise called as Aurora Australis. So what is the meaning of it is, it creates bright, it is a physical phenomenon which creates a bright and colorful lights in the sky. Okay, I'll show you the picture. So it is, we can see this light in the high latitude regions. Okay, so it is a natural light display in the sky. So we can see in the high latitude regions like New Zealand, Tasmania, Australia. So we can witness this southern lights in those places. I'll show you the picture. See, this one is the southern light. That is Aurora Australis, which is taken in Australia. Okay, so we can see the colorful light in the sky. See this picture, it is in New Zealand. Okay, you can see the light, sky lit up with the bright colorful lights. And this picture is the in Tasmania. Okay, so we can see this southern lights or Aurora Australis in the high latitude regions. It is a physical phenomenon which occurs in the sky. Okay, this is about southern lights. So it was rare to watch that in those months, that too from sea. So actually it was rare to watch the southern lights from the sea. Okay, so we were absolutely awestruck as we are not expecting it, to see the entire sky lit up in green light. Okay, so we were absolutely awestruck. Awestruck means they were absolutely
wondered, surprised.
Okay, so they were absolutely surprised as we were not expecting. So as they were not expecting it, to see the entire sky lit up in the green light. So they were very much unexpecting. So they were very much shocked, surprised to see the entire sky with the green colored light. There was bioluminescence. Dolphins swimming in the wake of the boat like our neighbors, and a variety of sea creatures. And also what they have seen is, they have seen bioluminescence. So what is mean by bioluminescence means, it is a chemical reaction that produces a light energy from the body of an organism. Okay, so it is a chemical reaction that produces light energy from, that is light from the body of an organism. Okay, so how that light will be produced is, okay, so that organism should contain luciferin. Okay, luciferin, it is the name of the chemical, luciferin. Okay, so when this chemical molecule reacts with oxygen, it produces bioluminescence in the body of the sea organisms, right? Okay, so this is the meaning of bioluminescence, that is, it is a chemical reaction that produces light energy in the body of the organism. So for producing this light energy, what is necessary is a chemical called luciferin is needed. So when this reacts with, when this molecule reacts with the oxygen, it produces light in the body of the sea organism, that is bioluminescence. See, this is an example for bioluminescence. Okay, so it is actually a sea organism, a type of fish, sea organism. We can see bioluminescence in its body. Okay, I'll show you some more pictures. So you might have seen these type of fishes in the sea, in the television and all, you have seen this. Okay, so this is also an example for bioluminescence. See, you can see this in this picture also. This, all this hair like structures or tentacles. Okay, this is also a sea organism. See, this is also one more example showing bioluminescence. See, this is also one more example for bioluminescence, a type of fish. So there was bioluminescence, dolphins swimming in the wake of the boat like our neighbors, and a variety of sea creatures. So what they have seen in the sea is, they have seen bioluminescence and dolphins. Okay, so dolphins were swimming in along with their boat like their neighbors, and also they have seen many variety of sea creatures. We spotted a dead sperm whale once, and we thought it was an island from a distance. It was so huge. Okay, so we spotted. Spotted means found. Okay. So they have seen a dead sperm whale once, and we thought it was an island from a distance. So what they have seen once is they have seen a dead whale. Okay, sperm whale. So like blue whale, sperm whale is also a kind of whale. They have seen a dead sperm whale in the sea, and they thought it as an island. So the path in and it's so such a huge size it was. So they thought that whale as an island. See. So see this picture. So once they have seen a blue whale. You can see the fish here, whale here. Okay, so it was actually dead. Okay, so they have seen a blue whale, and they thought that it was a huge island. Okay. We are not specialists, so whenever we spotted something in the sea, we had to Google it to learn more about the species. Okay, so we are not specialists. So they were not any, that is, they were not specialists, that is, they were not aware of all the sea creatures, sea animals. Okay, so whenever they spotted, whenever they found something in the sea, so whenever they are seeing something strange or new in the sea, they have to search in Google. Okay, so they have to Google it to learn more about the
spaces. Okay, so this is the answer to the question. How adventurous was your trip? So how adventurous it was? They have seen southern lights. They didn't expect it. They have seen bioluminescence. They have seen dolphins and variety of sea creatures swimming along with them in the sea. And they have seen, once they have seen a blue whale. It was dead and it was floating in the sea. But they thought that it was an island because such a huge size it was. Okay, so this was about their adventurous trip. So the next question is, how did your crew spend time deep in the sea? So how did your crew members spend time in the sea? Okay, so Swati Patrapali is answering. So what is her answer is, during circumnavigation, we picked up some hobbies and kept posting pictures of delicacies like golgappas and cakes. We also read books when the weather was pleasant and did some quailing and craft work. While team leader Joshi read comics and the Ramayana during her journey, I loved cooking as well, so I indulged in baking. I also liked crafting a lot, so I used to make lampshades. I love it when people appreciate the food that I cook, so I gave my crew members the best dishes that was possible on land with the limited resources that we had on the boat. Okay, so during circumnavigation, we picked up some hobbies. Okay, they had some hobbies. Okay, and kept posting pictures of delicacies like golgappas. Golgappas means nothing but pani puri. Okay, and cakes. Okay, so they have prepared pani puri and cake. We also read books when the weather was pleasant. Okay, so when the weather was very safe and pleasant, that is, a storm illadapo, when there is no storm, when there are no wind, when there is no hurricane. Okay, so when the weather is pleasant, they did some quailing and craft work. So what is quailing work is? It is also called as paper filigree. Okay, so it is an artwork that is making decorative designs using papers. That is called as quailing. It is also otherwise called as filigree. See, this is an example for quailing. Okay, so they are making decorative designs using the papers. All these designs were made using papers. This is called as quailing. It is an artwork. Okay, so we also read books when the weather was pleasant and did some quailing and craft work. While team leader Joshi read comics and the Ramayana during her journey. Okay, so what is the hobby of Vartika Joshi is? She'll be reading comic books. Okay, comics and the Ramayana. You know Ramayana. Okay, Ramayana and Mahabharatam. So she read Ramayana during her journey. I loved cooking as well. So I indulged in baking. So who loved cooking? Swati loved cooking. So she involved in cooking and baking. I also liked crafting a lot. Okay, so she was also interested in crafting. So I used to make lampshades. So what is mean by lampshades is? Okay, the cover for a lamp. Okay, lamp mail the cover pandra madri transparent or cover pandirukum illaya, that is called as lampshade. I love it when people appreciate the food that I cook. Okay, so she loved it when the people appreciated the food cooked by her. So I gave my crew members the best dishes that was possible on land with the limited resources that we had on the boat. Okay, so I loved it when people appreciate the food. So she loved it very much when others appreciated the food she had prepared. So I gave my crew members the best dishes. Okay, so she prepared best dishes for her crew members that was possible on land with the limited resources that we had on the boat. Okay, so with the limited resources they had on the boat, they also had prepared best variety of dishes. Okay, so this was the question. How did your crew spend time deep in the sea? So they had read comic books, they had prepared food items, they had done artwork, craft work. Okay, so all this was their time pass. So what is the answer of Vartika Joshi is,
6 is a great number. We were always entertained. Okay, so we 6 members, it is a great number. So we always entertained, that is we enjoyed a lot. We watched movies, listened to music, and you won't believe some of the goodies the crew wrestled upon in our tinny pantry, even while sailing in rough seas. We made parathas, baked cakes and breads, and even made halwa and rasagullas. Okay, so we watched movies. So they watched movies, they listened to music, and you won't believe some of the goodies. Goodies means some food items which is very tasty to, something which is very tasty to eat. Okay. Believe some of the goodies the crew rustled up in our tinny pantry. Okay, rustled up means that is the food item which could be prepared in a very short time. Tuck and ready pandra or food item. That is called as rustled up. Preparing in a short time. That is called as rustled up. The crew rustled up in our tinny pantry. Tinny means small. Pantry means a small room or a cupboard used like a kitchen. That is pantry. Even while sailing in the rough seas. So even when during sailing in the rough seas, they had prepared many food items. We made parathas, baked cakes and breads, and even made halwa and rasagullas. Okay, they had prepared parotas, they have baked cakes and breads, and even they had made prepared halwa and rasagullas in the sea. We celebrated festivals at sea. When we think about it now on land, we remember the Diwali we spent at sea. We celebrated 3 birthdays, including the first birthday of the boat. Also, specific occasions like crossing the equator, the international dateline and such. Okay, so they had celebrated even festivals at sea. Okay, so when we think about it now on land, so when they were recalling it now, we remember the Diwali we spent at sea. So they are recalling, remembering about the Diwali they have celebrated in the sea. We celebrated 3 birthdays, including the first birthday of the boat. Okay, they have celebrated 3 birthdays in the during their expedition. The first one is the birthday of the boat. Also, specific occasions like crossing the equator. Okay, so they had celebrated the specific timings, that is specific occasions like crossing the equator, the international dateline. So they have crossed the international dateline and such. So they have celebrated all those in the sea. Okay. So the next question is, what motivated you to fulfill the country's expectation? So what is your motivation? Okay. எது உங்களை motivate பண்ணச்சு? இந்த கண்ட்ரியோட எக்ஸ்பெக்டேஷனை நம்ம ஃபுல்ஃபில் பண்ணியாகணும். So which motivated you? So Swati is answering, we knew that the entire country was watching us and praying for us, so we never wanted them to have a single day thinking that we are in trouble. We knew that it is going to happen, but the people out there did not know what kind of challenges we were facing. So one of the motives that we kept in mind was that we did not want to frighten them. We decided that once the circumnavigating was over, we are going to show what we have actually gone through. Okay. So we knew that the entire country was watching us and praying for us. So they have gone for a 6 women crew members have gone for a expedition. So they know very well that the entire country was watching them and they were praying for their safety and for their success, everything. So we never wanted them to have a single day thinking that we are in trouble. So they don't want to have them. So that is, they don't want to disturb the people even for a single day by thinking that they were not in, that they were in trouble, they were in some problem. We knew that it is going to happen, but the people out there did not know what kind of challenges we were facing. Okay, so they definitely knows that. We knew that it is going to happen, but the people out there did not know. So the people out there means that is we people. Okay. They didn't know what kind of challenges we are facing. Enna madri challenges la they are facing.
Okay, the people doesn't know about it. So one of the motives that we kept in mind was that we did not want to frighten them. Okay, so one aim that they kept in their mind was they don't want to frighten the people in the land. Okay, so by explaining all those challenges they are facing in the sea. We decided that once the circumnavigating was over, we are going to show what we have actually gone through. Okay, so once they have completed their expedition, so what they have decided is, once they had completed their expedition, they want to explain everything to the people. So what problem they have faced, what happiness they have crossed, so what are all the things they have faced, they have wants to explain it, right? As a woman, how would you consider this expedition? Okay, so you are a woman. How would you consider this expedition? So how did you, what did you think about this expedition? So what is the reply of Vartika Joshi is, it is a matter of great honor and we could not have imagined anything better for our caste off. Of course, we being an all women team, it is a great boost to women in the country. But as we are going as sailors, and we as sailors have seen that the sea doesn't discriminate between genders. It is always gender neutral, and we have realized that gender does not play a role in sailing. But to boost the morale in the country and for more women to take in adventures like sailing, I feel it is great that all women team had been formed to undergo this expedition. Okay, so it is a matter of great honor. Honor means very a matter of proud. And we could not have imagined anything better for our caste off. So they could not have imagined anything else as a better thing than their expedition, which is going to be there. So that is which was their success. Of course, we being an all women team, it is a great boost to women in the country. Okay, so we being an all women team. So they are all a women team, all the six were women. It is a great boost to all the women. It is a great boost. Boost means it is a great enthusiasm, energetic to all the women in the country. But as we are going as sailors, and we as sailors have seen that the sea does not discriminate between genders. That is, the sea doesn't see any partiality, discrimination. Discrimination means partiality between the gender. Gender means as male and female. So far we have seen Dilip Donde, who had performed a circumnavigation. Okay, and we have seen one more person who had undergone solo circumnavigation, Abhilash Tommy, who had undergone non-stop solo circumnavigation. But this is the first time women are going for circumnavigation. So the sea is not seeing any partiality on the gender basis, that is as men and women. It is always gender neutral, and we have realized that gender does not play a role in sailing. So gender is not male or female, whatever it is not going to see any role in the sailing. But to boost the morale in the country. So what does mean by morale is emotional or mental condition with respect to confidence, especially in the face of hardships. Okay, so emotional condition, so that is the mental condition or the emotional condition that we are facing during our difficulties or the challenging. That is a difficult and challenging situation. How much we are having our mental confidence, mental strength, emotional strength, that is called as morale. Okay. So, but to boost the morale in the country and for more women to take in adventures like sailing, I feel it is great that an all-women team had been formed to undergo this expedition. So, according to the captain Vartika Joshi, what she is telling is, okay, to boost up the women empowerment in the country and also to encourage the women to perform such adventurous thing. Okay, so it is very great that they had formed all women team to undertake this expedition so that it will be a great example for the women empowerment in the country. It will be a great experience and it will be a great example for the women empowerment in the country. Okay, so with this we are completing this lesson. Actually, it is a very good lesson explaining about the women empowerment. Okay, so it says all about the women empowerment. So women are equally they are in position to the men. So as how men are performing many adventures, it is equally possible for all the women to perform all those adventures. Okay, so this is what we have seen in this lesson. So you can read once again, you can go through the lesson once again to have a overall sum up. Okay, so I hope every one of you have understood. So below there is an exercise. Read the statements given below and state whether they are true or false. If false, then write the correct answer in the space given. So you can do this yourself. Indian Navy's all women crew was the first ever to circumnavigate the globe. So you have to write true or false and you have to write the reason. Okay, so I hope every one of you have understood this lesson. Thank you for watching. Thank you.